So, my name is Thomas Lhermitte. I'm French, and I was born in Lille, north of France. And no way, I have a strong accent, sorry about that. But right now I live just near Geneva. I have my own society. I am a film producer and a director, especially in the automotive industry for car manufacturers. Yes, and I do this since 10 years.
Like initially kind of like get into this line of work then? I mean, was it kind of like a passion thing, or did you study it, or?
First, it's all about passion. I started 10 years ago as amateur, like filming all of my homies skateboarding. Yes, so the first 2 years I do a lot of skateboarding films, and I meet some guys at Red Bull, and I did some Red Bull films, and then it brings me in the professional industry by the skateboarding thing. So first it's all about the passion, and then I moved to automotive industry just because I'm a automotive fan and a motorcycle fan.
Just the type of stuff that you are passionate about, and the kind of the stuff that you film. I mean, that's the side of the business where not only do you have to be like a good filmmaker, but you got to be in shape. I mean, you're doing some crazy stuff there, right?
For sure, that's right. Especially in sports, when you do mechanic sports or just sports films, you have to be in shape and always find new stuff on the internet and trying and testing a lot of your gear, because when you are on set, you can't just arise and discover
Yeah.
this.
What kind of equipment then are you using? Because you got to be pretty nimble at some points, but then I see a lot of cars that look very cinematic, so I know you got like bigger setups. So how do you kind of like adjust?
Actually, I just have the last Blackmagic camera, the Pocket 4K with a Sigma Art lens. That's the minimum setup. And then I rent a lot of RED cameras because of the shutter, of the slow motion things, and just the Gemini by night with dual ISO, etc. So yes, I use a lot of RED camera and a lot of how to say grip rigs. Like, is that right? Grip rigs for cars. And I have a lot of box. Maybe you can see right here. Just here. Our box are just grip rigs for cars. That's because I love that angle when you put the camera behind the window or on the wheel, on the technical parts of the car, it's more dynamic. So that's, for example, you said about the Nürburgring. Last month we did a shot for Renault, the last Renault car, Renault Sport, and to enhance like it's a sport movie. So we put a lot of camera rigs on the car. So, but in the film industry, especially when you work on the web like me, you interviewed some directors or like more movie stuff or cinema stuff. For me, it's only on YouTube, So it doesn't matter if you have just a DSLR or big RED cameras, because it's all about the angles and the editing.
So in the kind of stuff that you're filming, are you doing a lot of traveling? Seems like you are.
I used to, but right now I'm just near Geneva, and I try to to work around here because I have my car, so it limits me to work by car, you know. So around Switzerland, Italy, France, Germany. So it's a lot of European gigs. But yes, sometimes for movies, for advertising, I had the chance to go to Asia 3 times, USA four, five times, to bicycle brand for filming bicycle events or something like that. Always about moving stuff on the road. So biking, automotive, and motorcycle.
You know, it's funny you said you do a little bit of traveling. I would consider that a lot of traveling.
Yes, it depends on the each profile. You know? But for me, once traveling on by months, it's okay. So yeah. I don't know if it's many or not, but yeah, well, 1 a month, approximately.
What are some of your favorite things that you've done, or some of the most crazy on some of those?
Didn't expect that. I need to think of it. Most crazy thing. For the first years of my career, I do a short movie. 20 minutes short movie about the personal life of James Bond. You know, what he's doing behind all the mission. You know, is it at home? Is maybe he have a wife or something like that? And I took 3 years to produce this movie, and all by myself. And 100 people joined me on this film. All the technical crew, professional actors, and car manufacturers, because I needed a lot of decors, or a lot of places, different places, but luxury places and luxury cars. So yes, that's the best project I have made.
Where can we see some of that stuff? Is it you said a lot of stuff?
It's not online right now, but in 2 months. We the campaign will rise on the web, and we do like really it's an advertising, like a 1 minute film, and very fast, very brutal.
Yeah. You know what? Another thing I noticed, even just like kind of like talking to you now, is like, first of all, your English is fantastic.
Thank you. For me, it's horrible, but yes, thank you.
You speak better English than a lot of people over here do, so congratulations.
thank you.
So in terms of like kind of like traveling, like how do you deal with like language barriers? Do you find that cinematography is a pretty universal language, or how do you deal with that?
Yeah, for sure, cinematography is a universal language, especially when you know the technical terms. It doesn't matter if you don't speak well, but if you speak with another camera crew team, camera crew or filmmaking team, we use the same tools. So maybe we can speak with your hands or something like that. So for me, it wasn't a barrier. For example, I do filming and managing a little team on Colorado 2 years ago with a local drone pilot. So he was born in Denver, etc. And we talked together, and everything was fine because we talk about the drone spec and the angles. And for me, I like to write in English my brief, my storyboard, or all the preparation things. And then, if I can give an advice for the filmmakers, is maybe to do that, to prepare your shot in English. If you will be with other English people or American people, maybe if you start from the bottom by writing in English, it will be very helpful on stage.
Yeah, no, that's fantastic advice, because that's one of the questions we ask, you know, always talk about. We ask a lot of people, are like, what are some of those, you know, points that you can give someone, you know, just kind of starting out? And I don't think someone would really kind of like think about what you just said. I think you automatically go to start about technical stuff, or
that's true,
creative stuff. But like, you know, just the on the lines of communication. That's great advice. So
cool. Happy to do that.
What else is on the horizon for you?
Sorry, can you hear me? I just have some troubles with it.
What's next for you? What's coming up?
What's next? I just bought another car to do that thing, bigger one. So the plan for this summer is to custom all the car. So swap, do a covering, black matte covering, and do all this rigging stuff on this car for this next month in July. So that's a big plan for this summer.
Yeah, just a real quick technical question. And you know, yeah. So is 8K catching on where you're at, or 8K yet?
For me, I do our videos on YouTube, I don't care about 8K. I just do 4K video stuff. Sometimes I shoot in 5K. So I have a little merge to scale or stabilize my videos, and I always do a 4K workflow because right now for me 8K it's not the goal for my stuff. So yeah, I don't think it should be awesome, but
I don't think. Wants to do 8K.
you need a strong connection, a very strong computer, and that's maybe too much. I prefer, for example, you know, this lens is really sharp. That's the Sigma R lens, and I use a lot of Black Promise films. As my colleague Nathan Anton, it's a little big up to my man, and I use a lot of filters. To destroy this sharpness, and so that brings this cinematic look that I am looking for. So I think in 8K it will not have this cinematic look. For example, the Arri Alexa, it's only on 2K, but that's incredible images. For example, in Drive movie or something like that, and by night and. You are just amazed when you see this type of movie, but it's in 2K.
Yeah. We have a lot of, I shouldn't say a lot, but we're starting to get some projects that are, you know, coming up at 8K, and I'm just not ready to go there yet. It's a lot of data. That's
yeah, for sure. You need too many hardware, and that's a lot of money too. Yeah. But maybe in the few next years, that's the future. I don't know. But...
We still have 24 hours in a day, and
yeah, that's it.
So Dan, did you have any other kind of questions you wanted to ask him?
Yeah. Tomas, so I got a question for you. So it sounds like you're like a one-man show. So, you know, what about like sound design, or what about when you need to scale up and you need a second camera? Do you have people that you collaborate with regularly?
Yes, that's a good one. First, how to say that? I master the technical, creative, and strategic aspect of video on the internet. That's why my clients are as eclectic as the project they interest me. But regularly, I hire, for example, each month from 1 to 10 specialized freelancers. Best for each project, because sometimes, for example, on a sport movie, you will hire another freelancer who knows sports and camera angles, etc. It's on case by case basis, but yes, for sure, it's quite hard to do a film alone.